Hello, I am Dr. Larissa Aviles-Santa, Director of Clinical and Health Services Research at the National Institute on Minority Health and Health Disparities at the National Institutes of Health. And welcome to the lecture on Health Disparities Research, Better Health Outcomes for All. In this lecture, I will briefly describe the concept of health disparities, illustrate the multidimensional levels of factors that influence health along the life course, and discuss some examples of publications on health or healthcare disparities and the multidimensional factors that could have influenced or contributed to the findings. What are health and healthcare disparities? There are differences in health and healthcare that are linked with social, economic, and or environmental disadvantage. They are beyond biological and or genetic differences. They are associated with challenges or obstacles to attaining healthcare. They are also associated with suboptimal quality of healthcare or inadequate access to optimal healthcare resources. And most, if not all, populations who confront health disparities have experienced discrimination or exclusion. Why it is important to study health disparities? The answer is purpose-driven, to ensure that we are identifying and defining them well, reducing and eliminating them wherever we find them, implementing and delivering the best healthcare practices for our patients and the populations that we serve and represent. In this diagram that was published by Dr. Hector Myers in 2009, he depicted the lifespan biopsychosocial model of cumulative vulnerability that explains the development of disease in minority groups in the US and very likely everywhere. He depicted or included elements that pertain to social demographic factors, genetic or biological factors, cognitive, psychosocial, cultural, health behaviors, etc. The National Institute on Minority Health and Health Disparities expanded on that model and has created this research framework that includes both domains and levels of influence that cover individual, interpersonal, community, and society levels of influence. It is important to note that both the previous one that Hector Myers developed and this one from NIMHD, both have a component or a very important aspect, which is time, life course. These elements, these factors are going to influence health along the life course of the individual. Inspired by those two models, I have created this diagram and this multidimensional diagram with factors and levels in clusters or constellations and how they could relate or interact with each other. These interactions, of course, can change over time. These clusters could also represent opportunities for interventions to reduce health disparities. I will refer to this diagram throughout this lecture. Now, let's take a look at some examples from publications that examined health or healthcare disparities. Now, in examining those publications, the aim is to discuss the examples and what factors the publications or the authors addressed, and what factors could also have played a role in the outcomes that they described. In no way, the discussion is about whether the conclusions were incorrect or correct, or talking about the methodologies that they used.